Welcome back for another episode of Control Your Brain, the podcast. I'm Dr. Trish Leigh, and today in this episode, we are going to talk about neurofeedback brain training and the process as I deliver it to be able to regulate your brain when it comes to chronic illness, attention, and addiction issues. Neurofeedback's incredibly powerful. I'm going to break down the 5 steps to move through my neurofeedback process, which is similar to other providers, but I will tell you, I am up there when it comes to being able to be skilled and knowledgeable in delivering neurofeedback and helping people achieve the outcomes that they want to be able to get at the end of a neurofeedback program, which I will discuss. Okay, so what are the 5 steps? Number 1, qualify. Number 2, evaluate. Number 3, shift. Number 4, stabilize. Number 5, maintain. We're going to maintain those gains once we achieve them. So let's start back at the beginning with qualify. So when it comes to working with me with neurofeedback, the first thing that I do is qualify if it's a good fit for us to work together. When I take on a new neurofeedback client, it's a relationship. I truly believe that. I know it might sound cheesy, but we get into a relationship and my team and I basically work hard to achieve that you gain the success that you want. And here we're talking about chronic illness, attention issues like ADHD and addiction. These issues aren't for the faint of heart. So when you join us, we're gonna make sure that we're pretty confident. I'm confident I can move you through this process and get you where you wanna go. That's the qualification process. At the same time, I only take a certain number of clients each month. So I need to make sure that the people that I'm working with are dedicated and committed to doing the things that I ask you to do and that you are willing to communicate your needs to me and we get into healthy communication. So it really needs to be a good fit. I want to have a good time. I want you to have a good time. And I especially want to work hard together to get the outcomes that you want. That's the qualification process. And what it looks like is you can either call Jamie and talk with her. A better way of doing that, Jamie's my executive assistant. A better way of doing it is you can schedule a consultation on my website. It is an investment, a deposit to secure the time to have the consultation with me, but that deposit moves forward into the program if you decide to have the assessment, which we'll talk about in a minute. But that way we can get on the same page and you know, I can tell you if it is going to be a good fit and if I have worked with people with your condition before, which mostly I have, my experience is there's breadth and depth, meaning I've worked with people with just about every struggle that's out there and I've been able to work deeply with those people. So there's not much I haven't seen or heard of or done. So I know when a lot of people start to work with me, they're like, oh my gosh, I can't believe you know about this because all the other doctors I worked with never heard of it. Not only have I heard of it, I've likely helped someone get to the other side of it. That's what we do in the qualification process. It can be really important for me, really important for you. The way that my program works, as of this recording at least, is I have 2 cohorts each month. There's a cohort that begins at the 1st of the month, one that begins at the 15th of the month. And I move people through a sequence that's very intentional and deliberate within those 15-day cycles. It's really powerful. So if you are interested in neurofeedback and you want to know if it's a good fit working with me, please sign up with on the website for a consultation. The risk is low because your deposit does move forward. Okay, so that's the qualification process. Let's move on to number 2, evaluation. So evaluation is really important, and I provide a very comprehensive evaluation. I call it a neurobiopsychosocial approach. And in terms of science, it covers a whole person. I look at you as a person and your life situation or circumstances. And I call it a situation or circumstance because there's something that you are dealing with right now, but it is not your life. It's the situation or the circumstance that you are in. Even chronic illness, even if you've been dealing with that thing for years and years and years, it's a situation that you can get beyond. Even if it's addiction, you've been dealing with it for decades, it's a situation you can get beyond. Even if your kiddo has ADHD and you've heard from another doctor that ADHD is an organic thing and you can't ever get rid of it, ADHD is something you can get beyond. So in the evaluation, what I do is I perform a QEEG brain map. That is using electroencephalogram. You have to purchase the hardware yourself, which currently I'm using the Muse headband. I've been using it for a long time. It has 5 sets of sensors on the inside. You wear it on your head. And when you invest in the evaluation, we mail you a sensor and paste, and you connect the sensor into the port on the Muse, and you're able to take your own QEEG brain map at home using specialized software. So the hardware we use is the Muse. The software is a specialized provider professional platform that we give you access to in the form of an app. And then I have a website that is secure and I'm able to get into, and I can see your brain map the minute you take it. So what happens is, in the neurological aspect of the assessment or the evaluation, I'm looking at every area of your brain and I'm analyzing how it's performing in terms of speed, which is a very important thing to me, and a wide variety of functional parameters. Now, I can see exactly how your brain is performing and if it is performing less than optimally, and if so, how far away from optimally your brain is performing. So basically, how significant the dysregulation in your brain pattern is. Now, the beauty of that is you can see it too in the app. Your brain map pops up in the app. And of course, if you don't talk to me, you don't really know what it means. But then we get on a Zoom for an hour and I break down every aspect of your brain map for you. I walk you through it. I make sure you understand it and we have discussion around it. Check. Neurological. We do that. Now, biological, you fill out a detailed history and you also fill out a form on how you live your life currently in terms of how you're using your brain. At least that's how I see it. So then if there's any issues you have in your body, biological processes that are also not working because of the neurological dysregulation, I'm able to connect the dots on that in a way that other people are not able to see. Thankfully, my training is wide and vast. I have degrees in many different areas. And although they seemingly are unrelated to some people, the way that they come together is I'm able to connect dots that other people don't even see as being connected. Very powerful in terms of the biological, physical symptoms you are experiencing. I can bring them back to not only aspects of your history, but also to the neurological functioning in your brain performance pattern. Very powerful for clearly setting a course for solving the issues that you're struggling with. It's a clear path forward when we connect these dots. Massively powerful. So that's the biological aspect. What that looks like is different for all people, but in terms of ADHD, it might be impulsive behavior or lack of attention, difficulty focusing, a lot of body movements. If it's Parkinson's disease, it's the motor disorder. If it's aphasia, it's difficulty either formulating words or understanding words that come at you. So those aspects are the biological tend to be cognitive, mental, or physical. But either way we look at it and we get to the bottom of them. So that's neuro, biological is number 2. Number 3 is psychological, and those are mental health parameters. Seemingly, to me, they are also neurologically based. So we know anxiety, depression, mood disorders, anything that falls in the psychological space does have an underlying neurological brain performance pattern as seen on EEG that is causative, it's causing it, or it's correlated. It's perpetuating it, making it worse. I can show you that in the brain map, connecting the dots to the psychological piece. And so if you struggle with anxiety or depression and your brain is dysregulated, when we regulate your brain, your anxiety and depression decrease. That's how it works. And that's what we do in the next steps of the program. But first, we have to evaluate where it's coming from. If you struggle with misophonia, which is a sound sensitivity that many people have, I can see it in the temporal and frontal lobes of your brain. And when I see it there in this very focal pattern, and we regulate those areas, You can process sounds in real time and you no longer have to deal with misophonia. That is how this works. So it's neurological, biological, psychological. The social aspect is hugely important because part of being human is being connected to other people. And those relationships can be the greatest areas where we can show up as ourselves and work on how we can hardwire in the new, better brain pattern. So what does socialization look like? It looks like the classroom for children. It looks like the workplace and the home for many people. It looks like social relationships, how you show up in them, whether there's social anxiety or not, and how those environments are impacting your brain performance pattern. It tends to be a two-way street. I can evaluate those and connect all the dots and then make a plan for you to succeed. That's what happens in the evaluation. So when we meet for that hour, I've already analyzed everything that I've just spoken about. We discuss it and I can make some really strong recommendations moving forward in terms of regulating your brain on an unconscious level using neurofeedback, which I'll share in a second, and then also using coaching where we address some of those subconscious patterns that you've been programmed with either by yourself or your culture, your family or your community, or consciously, you know things that are impacting you. You just don't know how to solve them. And that happens a lot with people that I work with. So that's unconscious, subconscious, and conscious rewiring of your brain using neurofeedback and coaching. So we qualify, then we evaluate. Then I set the neurofeedback system for very specific individualized protocols for the sites in your brain that need it, with the protocols that best serve your needs. I'm able to come up with individualized protocols that I can keep my eye on measurably, and I share with that with you over time. So just to reiterate, in the brain map, you can see with your own eyes the brain dysregulation. When we start neurofeedback, you can see progress. You can see where you started, where you are now, and where you need to get to for the optimal brain performance pattern. Data is immensely important to me, and I share it with you so that you can connect the changes in your behavior and how you think and perform and act to the changes in your brain performance pattern. Very powerful. Okay, so after qualifying and evaluating, then we shift. So what I'm looking for within the first month of neurofeedback is a shift in your brain performance pattern. I'm trying to get the just right response to intervention to push your brain as fast as I can, but not too fast so that it's uncomfortable. That's the beauty of neurofeedback. It's non-invasive and it's all natural. It doesn't put anything into your brain. It teaches your brain to make more of the speeds for calm focus and less of the speeds for distraction, overwhelm, fatigue, anxiety, hypervigilance. It brings your brain down into the calm, focused, optimal green zone mode. And I'm looking for that shift to happen, hopefully within the first month or two of the neurofeedback program. I ask people to commit to a 4-month program as of this recording. 4 months is what you commit to, knowing it takes some time to shift your brain. And then in the next step, I'm looking for stabilization of the new, better brain pattern. I show that to you every single time we meet. We meet one time a month. So you're able to use unlimited neurofeedback sessions using the professional app. And then we meet for the coaching sessions once a month. And if you need support in between meetings, we're here for you. The beauty of using the professional platform is you can use it at home with unlimited frequency and in any environment that you want, but hopefully a sanctuary. But you're able to get a lot of sessions, and using the provider, the professional provider, you can stream Netflix and Apple and watch your favorite shows during neurofeedback, or you can watch YouTube, or there's also audio and games. So basically, it's a very passive treatment at the beginning, but I like to transition people to a more active treatment over the 4 months so they gain more control of their brain performance pattern. That's my goal for you. But at first, when you're watching shows or you're streaming YouTube, your brain is getting a workout while your mind is entertained. You don't have to think about it. That's what makes it unconscious. So your brain's getting that shift that we're looking for, and we're able to see it on the data. Then in the last 2 months of the program, we're looking for that. It's a line. That's why I keep making this hand gesture for a line. We see the line come down and we see it stabilize, meaning that your brain is using the optimal pattern and you'll feel those aspects show up in your life. I got an email this morning of a little kiddo that I'm working with, and we started working together a month ago. His dad's a skeptic. If you're listening, yes, it's you. And you know what I told you about loving a good skeptic. His dad was a skeptic, and the teachers requested a parent-teacher conference. So he had a phone call this morning, and the teachers told him that they have seen gains in focus, attention, handwriting, and behaviors in the last month. Boom! I'm calling that a shift, and it's such a beautiful thing. So that's what I'm looking for. And then I'm looking for stabilization over time, which of course I share with you. So it's 4 months of shifting and stabilizing. Now, a lot of people have the question, what if I don't shift and stabilize in the 4 months? After that, you can continue month to month with no commitment, just month to month, and common courtesy of we're communicating every month and we're on the same page. You can see how close you are to where you want to get, and you can see your behaviors and your goals showing up in your life. You decide if you want to continue. When you're ready to discontinue because your brain is optimized and your life is wonderful, then we transition to the fifth stage, which is maintenance. I offer a maintenance program, which is quarterly sessions for the year after we've done neurofeedback together. What I want to ensure is that we've rewired your brain and we've seen that stabilization, but I need to hardwire it in. And I want to make sure on the quarter that your brain looks better than ever, like it should according to science. Very powerful. So when you sign up for the maintenance program, you do a neurofeedback session each quarter. It creates a plot point on the main graph that I use. And then we get together and we review it, and I show you how your brain is still improving over time for lasting hardwired in change. It's wonderful. So these are the five steps in the neurofeedback program with me, Dr. Trish Leigh and company. First, we qualify, we make sure it's a good fit. Second, we evaluate full comprehensive neurological, biological, psychological, and social evaluation. I point you in a clear direction forward. Then we start using neurofeedback. You can stream shows or YouTube to make it really easy. And we're looking to shift your brain performance pattern within the first few months. You're able to see a ton of data that shows up in the app every single time you do a session. It's easy to follow and it's very motivating and inspiring. And then I show you even more data in our monthly meeting, where we also do a coaching session where I use the subconscious and conscious coaching strategies to help you have that new, better brain pattern show up in your daily life. That helps us to stabilize the new healthy brain pattern. And then through maintenance, we hardwire it in over time for the rest of your life, and you sail off into the sunset. Yes, dramatic, but also very true. That's how the neurofeedback process works. And again, it's a relationship. So if you're looking for help with chronic illness, and I've seen and helped people with most of them, honestly, I only will tell you that I'm confident that I can help you if I am. And when it comes to neurofeedback, it really can be a difference maker in being able to regulate your brain and to be able to put that part of your life behind. When it comes to attention issues and addiction, it's the same thing. So if you're remotely interested, please sign up for a consultation with me so I can help you in this process, so that within the next 6 months, you can be in a different place, achieving the goals and well on your way to living the life that you want and deserve. All right, if it feels good, please go over to drtrishleigh.com. If you go to the QEG brain mapping page, you can read all about the brain map assessment and what it's like. There's a page that says why neurofeedback. Peruse around. You can look at my method. It's all based on science. I've been doing this for a very long time, and I've helped a lot of people, and I would absolutely be honored to help you in your journey. All right. Until next time, control your brain or it'll control you.